VCR party. It's Tuesday night. I'm Joe. That's Nick. That's George. That's Steve. And boy, oh boy, do we have a fun show for you tonight. Don't we, Nick, or do we not?
First of all, what's going on behind you? There's a solo flex. You're on like a couch that's more like a bed. I mean, it's like, what are the things?
I slept on this couch before, actually. No, I'm over at Jakester's house. Jakester is mine and Nick's buddy since like sixth grade. Well, I've known him since fourth grade. You've known him since sixth grade. And yeah, I'm at his place. Because I took a last-minute trip, I came back to Wisconsin. My place is nuts because there's niece and nephews over there and stuff. It's too quiet. My parents' Wi-Fi is shitty. So I came to Jakester's, and I was like, I want to do it from your basement because, like, I love – and I, by the way, that's a Bowflex over there. And you know what? I was going to save this for nice things, but I'll do it now. I'll just show it right now.
Okay. There's
Bowflex back there. I was wondering, like, does he actually use it? Not a chance. And –
Tom makes aspirational purchases.
Yes.
I think that's.
And I wanted to see how much dust was actually on it.
Okay.
So I put my finger across, and there's a lot of dust.
Oh yeah.
Yep. So.
That hasn't been touched in years.
No, that hasn't touched a human ever. Yeah. Yep.
Wow, so you're coming live from a basement in Wisconsin.
Yep, and I drove this week. I drove from New York to here in Wisconsin. I brought my two cats with me, too. I'm lucky to be here right now. I was in the car, and I for some reason thought it would be better if I just let them out and kind of wander around. Terrible, terrible mistake. First thing he did, the boy cat did, he climbed, and I'm on the interstate in Pennsylvania going 75 miles an hour. He goes right underneath the brake. It's the very first thing he does. He goes right underneath the brake, and I can't brake, otherwise I'm going to crush him. So I grab like a handful of fur, and I just rip him out. I'm like, you dumb. So I rip him out. I throw him back, and then he's walking along the side, and he starts rolling down the window. He puts his paw on the electric window. It rolls all the way down, 75 miles an hour. I can't roll it up because his paw is still on it, and I'm barely even watching the road at this point. Oh, I'm lucky to be here. So I kept him in his crate the rest of the way. He just yowled and meowed, and it was I almost turned around.
But, you had to teach him a lesson.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, that might be payback, because whenever we're on the road and you're having stomach issues, you hit the child lock so that I can't roll down the window. And in this case, your cat taught you a valuable lesson.
Yeah, this is a great bit, by the way. I want to pass on to the Melindas out there. So, yeah, if you blast a really bad one, hit the child lock so that Nick can't roll down the windows. It works. It just, you get the best response. Because
it's a road trip style Dutch oven.
Exactly. Could have put a
little
better.
Little did Joe ever know.
Well, yeah, so. All right. We're lucky you're live. And we always like to start the show with a found footage festival classic. Here's today's.
You caught me with my pants down, but no one sells carpet or waterbeds for less.
Jeff Krulik from Heavy Metal Parking Lot, one of the co-directors of Heavy Metal Parking Lot with John Hine, made a follow-up to that called Heavy Metal Picnic, which we actually sell on our website. And I don't know if it's on our Super Long Play Club, our streaming service.
I think it is.
Yeah.
I think it is.
So you can watch this. And basically, it's a documentary about... it's the 35th anniversary. It was in May. We passed it, but of this event called the Full Moon Jamboree, which is a Washington, D.C. area. I think it was in Maryland. Heavy metal outdoor 3-day event where people just kind of camped out. And somebody brought a video camera, and Jeff gave us the footage. Was this Rudy Childs? Does this come from Rudy Childs too?
Yeah, Rudy gave us to us. And I feel like this metal, heavy metal festival, I don't think it was like sanctioned. It wasn't very well organized. It was just like, I think maybe just a group of dudes said, hey, let's throw a party on this land here. And, you know, they didn't get security. They didn't do, you know, there was no EMT.
Right. No. The streets weren't grounded. I mean,
zero regulations on this. This is just a huge party anarchy.
Yeah, I'm feeling a little nostalgic for big group gatherings, and so I wanted to play this. And also, it's the 10th anniversary of the movie, which you can find at foundfootagefest.com. So here's some highlights from the home movie from Heavy Metal Picnic.
We're at the 3rd annual Rock Fest down in Potomac, Maryland, and we are rocking, buddies. Nobody can handle themselves. Nobody is in control because we are rocking, goddammit. This is the rock capital of the world, and we are doing it right. Tune back for later comments.
Are you really with CBS?
Fuck no, we stole this shit.
Oh, cool.
We're having a good time. No one's been born, no one's died, but hell, we're having a good time here.
This is Dinker Ryan here. We are about to experience the beautifulest eyes in the world here. Look at these eyes. These are the bluest eyes I have ever seen in the world. I swear to God.
Got something up.
Sandra. Sandra Connors.
Old-timey Irish fighting style. Is that how you fight, Steve?
Yeah, he's got his face kicked in hard.
Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa!
We're having so much fun.
Fucking A right, better believe it!
Reagan's a Nazi. Reagan's a fucking Nazi, man.
I gotta tell him some shit.
Man, Ronald Reagan, man.
No further comments. No further comments.
That's what I'm saying, man. Get stoned through the bone. Stoned through the bone, man. All the way down.
Hey, dog, what you got to say for yourself?
I do have LSD for sale, you know, let all the people out there know.
Is it CBS or what? Yeah. Rock and roll party!
Yeah!
Ain't nothing but rock and roll.
All right.
That's heavy metal. Oh, here's an update, by the way. These guys, the LSD guy and the woman next to him on the right, are married. They're still married. They're a very sweet couple. And we talked to him for, I don't know what we talked to him for. Do you remember, Joe?
I don't remember this at all.
Yeah.
Anyway, I remember the story.
Don't remember talking to him.
Yeah, I think it was maybe for one of the Onion shows that we did for AV Club or something. But anyway, yeah, we got an update for them. And they're featured in the documentary as well. So check it out. Happy anniversary to the Heavy Metal Picnic Rock and Roll Party.
And you know what? I don't think that we actually have that on a DVD, because I think that Jeff was making the documentary. He didn't want that to be on the DVD. So that was a very special edit right there. Not a lot of people get to see that.
That's right. That wasn't on our found footage DVD. Yeah.
No, it was not on a found footage DVD at all.
All
yeah.
right. Well, yeah. Happy anniversary. Viewer questions? Any viewer questions for the usually we have viewer questions that at this point in the show.
Yep.
And it's a segment called That It A Done.
That It A Done. That's it. That It A Done. Right there.
Sally writes in, you probably showed the entire show to your Ravioli's guy at some point, but I don't remember it off the top of my head. Well, first of all, how do you not remember what episode this came from? Can you show more of the comedy bit in context so I can understand what the guy is actually talking about and why he makes those weird noises? Thank you, Sally. So, yeah, Shows for Raviolis, we renamed our show and tell segment, the bulk of VCR Party, Shows for Raviolis, based on a clip from Stairway to Stardom. And it's a comedy routine. Do you remember the guy's name?
Yeah, Richie Triolo. And I pulled the whole clip. It's 3 minutes long. You want to watch the whole thing?
Let's do it.
Sally asked for it. We played it before. I think we played it once before. But, you know, anytime somebody asks for Richie Triolo, I'm not going to say no.
And not only that, I think this is one of the things a lot of people are like, there's so many inside jokes. It's like, give them the chance to see it again. I think.
Yes, exactly. Okay. All right, good. All right, we're going to do it. All right, here he is, Richie Triolo from Stairway to Stardom. The origin of...
Let's bring out our next guest. We got a comic.
Oh, yeah.
I know. I heard him. He's good. Yeah.
His name is Richie Triolo. Is that it?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, here you go, Richie.
Thank you, Frank. How's everybody doing? Having a good time?
Yeah.
Any Italians out there?
Yeah.
Come on, let's see your raviolis. Show us your raviolis. I'm Italian. I was brought up by very strict Italian parents. And you know, the kind of religious Italian parents that if you go in the bedroom, they have a picture of God shaking hands with Frank Sinatra in the bedroom.
That's not a terrible joke.
My father was very strict with us. Like, if we did something wrong, like we drew hair on the St. Anthony statue and make him look like one of the Beatles, he would always smack us to a certain beat or rhythm. That for every word he said, he had a smack like, I told you not to. Oh, my God. My father became
a
contender.
The lighter side of abuse.
My mother was the athlete in the family. Like, if we did something wrong, she'd hide in the kitchen. She'd put on Jerry Cooney trunks, a ripped bathrobe, and a mouthpiece, and wait for us to come in the kitchen. And she'd chase us around the table like, when I get a hold of you, you're going to wish you were dead. I used to run in my room and lock the door. And she'd come up to the door, open the door.
He was clearly wearing a hat here, right?
Yeah.
He clearly showed up.
Either that or a headband, but I would say hat.
Yeah.
He would have still been wearing the headband. He took the hat off for this, yeah.
Going to hit you.
Oh, wait. I just want to back this up so that you can hear this child abuse story. There's another child abuse story here.
This is how people
she come up to the door.
Yeah.
Hit back then.
Open the door. I'm not going to hit you. I know you're going to hit me, Mom. I know you're going to hit me. Open the door. I'm not going to hit you. Now, I waited for everything to get very quiet. I opened the door just a crack. She would put her hand through, like the Frankenstein monster. Pull me by my hair and give me a tour of the house. One year, she pulled my hair so much, I started to look like Gandhi. Thank you, Mama. Thank you. I feel very religious now. Anyway,
that wasn't my.
I was gonna say, the city was was doing a lot of things this past couple of weeks.
What was I gonna say?
Real polished routine here.
Anyway, I was gonna say, the city was doing a lot of things this past couple of weeks, and
the city was doing a lot of things.
Celebrated the 50th anniversary
of
the movie Kong. One day I'm looking up.
He's talking about King Kong.
About things this past couple of weeks, and remember they celebrated the 50th anniversary of the movie King Kong. One day I'm looking up, I see King Kong on the building. The next day I come back, I see this big brown thing stuck on the side. It looked like he climbed up, took a dump, and left. What are they gonna do? What are they gonna do? Oh, kidsy. What are they gonna do for the 50th anniversary of Deep Throat? Have a giant mouth going up and down the building.
We didn't need that part.
Craziness.
We could have done that in our heads.
Sorry, and, what else happened in the city this year?
I don't mean to note this guy to death, but
who's the Richie Triolo here, Nick? You or Richie
yeah,
Triolo?
Sorry, I'll let I'll let Triolo do his thing.
Craziness. And what else happened in the city this year? St. Patrick's Day Parade was a riot. Anyone go to St. Patrick's Day Parade? There was that nut taking this road test.
He didn't really want an answer, did he?
No.
It's just like, this is what comedians do. They ask people in the audience.
Yeah, it's not like Tilly was about to jump in here.
Yeah.
What, George?
There was that nut taking this road test during the parade. Did you see? I have never seen so many Irish people sober up so fast in my life.
When Irish eyes are smile.
Oh, truck it! Get out of the way. Thank God nobody got.
Get out of the way.
Again, a pretty serious incident. A madman drives into the St. Patrick's Day parade.
Yeah, somebody wants to get out of the way of the truck that's going to
hit him. Irish eyes are smile.
Oh, truck it! Get out of the way. Thank God nobody got killed during that parade. One poor guy got hit by the truck. He got up, looked right in the television camera. Automobile Club of America. Did you have to be that good? Thank you. Thank you.
That must have been reference. A commercial at the time or something?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'm a big fan of commercial references in comedy bits.
Yeah.
Because it's just timeless. It's absolutely, it's always evergreen. Everybody's always going to remember those slogans from the commercials.
That stood the test of time. So, Sally, that'd have done.
That'd have done, Sally.
And now it's to the segment that Richie Triolo is the namesake for. It's Show Us Your Raviolis.
Come on, let's see your raviolis. Show us 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 your raviolis.
All right, we have a special guest who's Tom Osmond, who runs TCmedia.com, which is an archive of all old local commercials and television, just hundreds of hours of tapes from old TV from Minnesota.
You know what's cool is that there are more and more people popping up doing this. So we got Rick in Milwaukee, and now we have Tom, and I think that's it. But there are two people now who are collecting old local media, and I feel like more people should do this.
It's really, yeah. It's
we'll
a
have
good,
you on the show. We'll yeah. have you on the show.
Please reach out if you have collected old videotapes from whatever region you grew up in. So without further ado, here's Tom
Huntsville.
Osmond.
The Huntsville guy.
Oh, yes, Huntsville Rewind, of course.
Yes,
yeah.
yes.
All right, here's Tom Osmond. Tom, welcome to VCR Party. I'm excited to have you. I was telling Joe last week and our viewers that I came across your website and found Discoverama, which I played a little bit, some highlights from Discoverama last week, and which was kind of like one of our favorite public access shows, Stairway to Stardom. And so I wanted to, I reached out to you because I saw that you had a ton more like early local TV stuff from Minnesota, which is where we spent a lot of time. And I just wanted to get you on to show some highlights and talk about what you do.
Well, I appreciate it. In fact, I'm very happy to be here. I've been following you guys from at least the mid 2000s when you were doing a high speeder show and then all the subsequent ones, including the U of M show. I went too many years ago.
Nice. Oh, you're a veteran then. You're well versed. Yeah. Okay. Awesome.
Yeah, I was going to say you're one of 15 people at the U of M show, probably. Thanks. Thank you for going to that.
I don't even remember that one. What was that one?
We did a Wintry Day back in 2014.
I remember that. Yes, I do remember that.
And I thought it was going to be at one of the U of M theaters. It's like a rec center. So they're playing, I think, Tippy Cups, and then walked over to see your show. and I think I was the oldest one there, and I was over 30, but probably at least 10 years older than anyone that was there.
Yeah. Our general rule about college shows is you can show up even if you don't go to school there, but just like wear a backpack, just pretend you're a student. So we're always grateful when people like you come to the shows.
Bring a hacky sack or something. That's what college kids use, right? Yeah.
Pretend you just got back from the quad. So talk about TCmedia.com. What is it? How did you come across this footage?
TC Media now, I call it, because many years ago when I tried to get TC Media, it was not used. So
TCmedia.com,
and that one was available.
Great.
And the site is about, about 13 years old now. And my site was kind of born from starting on YouTube because I had hundreds of tapes. We had one of those really big VCR machines in the early 80s, and the tapes were really heavy like bricks, and we recorded everything for whatever reason. And then I thought it was fascinating many years later to have all these commercials, and really the local footage of Minnesota is what got me to the website. The commercials, the cut-ins, the late-night TV, 6 hours of late-night TV, that's kind of my gold. You brought up Discoverama. COVID's been a great thing for TC Media Now because people tell me they don't record local commercials or news. I say, no, you do, because you didn't hit stop on your VCR. And then I have 5 hours of local footage after that movie they watched. Then we go into, after the infomercial, we replay the news, and then the late night spots that people pay maybe $30-$40 to get a commercial on TV in the mid 80s.
Yeah.
That's what I find fascinating. And that's what I put on TC Media Now.
Yeah. So let me play a little bit so people can get an idea of more of what this is. There's a morning show called Good Company. And I cut two different clips from this to show because I love these chipper hosts and some of the segments. This is just one morning, one average morning in the early 80s.
And because people will correct you, it's actually an afternoon show. And
oh, it's afternoon.
When I post things on my Facebook page, I always think that I'm really strange with details. People are way more detailed than me, and they say, wrong. It's actually like this. Like,
no, right, you got to get it right. You got to get it right. If you do one of these shows, you got to get it right.
You prevented me from having to make an apology later. So
I think you still should.
All right. I'm sorry. Here's a little bit of a Good Company.
I'm Steve Adelman.
I'm Sharon Anderson.
Today on Good Company, we are going to show you the latest in talking gadgets, including a talking car.
And Beth Wood is on the scene at a local warehouse sale where you can get designer fashions at bargain prices.
Also on Soap Talk, Julie Brown is going to introduce us to Delilah of One Life to Live.
And an expert is going to show us how we can get our daily exercise and clean the bathroom all at the same time.
From the Twin Cities, it's Good Company with your hosts, Steve Adelman and Sharon Anderson.
It seemed like fun.
Field hosts, Gary Lumpkin.
Gary Lumpkin.
Gary Schendel. And field reporter, Beth Wood.
Hey, what we have here are the latest gadgets that talk back to you. This is some games and some other things. And Sharon, what is this you have over here?
Well, this is the latest in pop machines. This is from the Coca-Cola company. Come here.
It talks?
Yes. Do you have a microphone?
Yeah.
We might need that. I'm not sure how loudly this thing's going to let us know what's going on. But anyway, you know, sometimes you can get a Coke.
Hi, I'm a talking vending machine for Coca-Cola.
Hi.
See, I'm just trying to get a drink.
Oh, listen, it's the Coke theme. That's funny. Are you going to stop or? Okay, do I have to push the button to make you stop?
Make
okay.
Your selection, please.
Thank you. See, I had to put enough money in before she let me make my selection. Okay, how about a Coke? Thank you.
Thank you for using the talking vendor.
Sure.
Come again.
wait a minute. What about my change?
Oh, were you supposed to get change?
Hello?
Wait, now it's going to say, tough luck. This is a Chrysler LeBaron convertible.
Uh-oh, already.
It's a daddy's car.
Let's try this again. You open the thing up. Now, the keys are already in the car.
Chrysler
so
LeBaron convertible.
That shouldn't be. So listen what happens when you open up the door.
So as I told you once, I'm not going to tell you again.
Let's try something else here. Close the door. All right, here we go. It's on. They're on.
It's real rejection when machines won't talk to you.
All right. Open the door, turn off the ignition.
Oh, and I was charitable. I cut this down.
Yeah!
I said, don't forget
the psychiatrist bills that you're going to incur when the car will talk to you are going to be amazing. Anyway, this is a Chrysler LeBaron. $15,000 sticker price courtesy of Bloomington Chrysler Plymouth. We want to thank them for coming along. What's your name again?
Bob
Lima was here to kind of help us out to get a talk. Those are the latest in talking gadgets. And when you're really good, you can get it to talk to you with no problem.
That's right.
We'll
nothing
be right
worked.
Back. Stay with us.
Nothing worked.
And I think that's one of those shilling shows where they're like shilling for stuff. It's not like actually like getting press releases, because we've tried to get onto some of these morning news shows, and they're like, it costs $1,500 in order for you to get a segment on this particular
show. Fun fact, they were married, so the host there, they met on the morning, they were morning show hosts, then they went national for about 2 months, and then they came back here locally and did that show off and on for 17 years.
17 years? Wow. Well, I was surprised at how ambitious that show was, because they had like remotes where they were at a horse stable. They were at a big like sample sale for clothing. They had a guy fly with the Red Barons in the back of one of those biplanes. This is in one episode of this local afternoon show. Plus all the talking gadgets.
You know, the guy who, the field host, 2 years ago, I used to reach out to these people locally and say, hey, do you have your tapes? And surprisingly, 90% of them said, yes, please tape them. And I remember one time meeting Gary Lumpkin at a parking lot with a van full of tapes. And little by little, the field host segments are on TC Media now. And bull riding, horseback riding, kayaking, Disney World, school lunch, you name it. He went everywhere. Every show he did one or two segments of something wacky.
You know what I want to go back and look at? Remember in the movie Fargo, when she's at home, the scene where she gets kidnapped?
Yeah.
She's at home and she's watching a morning news show or an afternoon news. I think she's watching this one. I think she's actually watching this.
I just rewatched Fargo. I think they taped that. But you know what? We should go look at it, because I just rewatched Fargo and I didn't even put that together. But you're right. It might have been that.
But the cheesy joke that they do in that scene in Fargo is exactly like a cheesy joke that they would do in this.
Yeah.
So I think it's them.
Because they were – so you would always have like the Boy Scout, Girl Scout troop would be in the audience. And then you'd say, hey, am I good company? Or you'd model the fall fashions. It was it was kind of the place to maybe say I was on TV. That and the State Fair.
I have another clip from that I want to show later. But the next one I want to get into is something from the Minnesota Twins. This is like a real early TV stuff. Do you know what we're talking about?
I got a few Twins things on, so I'm not sure.
Well, let's just watch it.
Come on, big man.
Last year, this man hit 388, the best in 20 years. He led the league in hits, triples, and runs scored. He won his sixth batting title, was voted most valuable player, and made the cover of Time. But Rod Carew wants more.
I want that gold glove, and I want it bad.
Rod Carew, he just gets better and better.
This is Clive, our top model, showing off the latest in stadium fashions. The white vinyl look, so very, very now. Note the rich Twins decal, the waterproof sleeves, the ventilation holes. Absolutely adolescent she-she. And yours free if you're 16 or under. Sunday, the 28th, at the Met. Compliments, the Minnesota Twins, and English leather. Thank you, Clive.
You know, ever since I came home to Minnesota, I've been hearing how the Twins are hurting without Carew. Well, don't count on it. Guys like Erickson, Goltz, and Marshall have given us some of the best pitching we've had in years. New guys like Landreau and Jackson have already helped us. And Roy Smalley's become a star. Sure, a lot of people have written us off.
Well, that's okay.
Right, because now we've got something to prove.
Tell them like it is, Coos.
Right, right.
The Minnesota Twins. This year, we've got something to prove.
I like that commercial.
Imagine being the only kid on the block who never owned a frog. The only kid who didn't win at marbles. The only kid who couldn't go to summer camp. And worst of all, imagine being the only kid on the block who wasn't there for jacket day at the Met.
Life is a bummer.
This Sunday, your kid gets another chance. Because when the Twins play Kansas City, every kid 16 or under will get a free team jacket. Compliments of Jack's Cafe and the Twins. So remember, Sunday is jacket day.
Every cloud is a silver lining.
I think that kid's great.
I think, you know, Minnesota
come around and you'll still see people walking downtown Minneapolis with those jackets. Once in a while, they are as flimsy as they are, they, you know, after the nuclear war, those will still be around because people still walk downtown with those.
Wow. I got to say that Twins commercial where it was the whole team kind of walking and saying, the people are writing this off. Whenever you ask an athlete to act, it never goes well. They're terrible actors. 99% of them are terrible. I thought everybody in that commercial nailed it. And I was just like, are these actors playing? No, these are the real guys. Yeah.
That would have been during the Twins' dark period. So you can tell the budget wasn't high. We're not talking the Chicago Cubs, New York Yankees budgets for marketing. And
yeah.
At that time, the Twins ownership, they own the Twins, not like modern day ownership where you own five different things and then the sport from the side. The Twins were one of the last ball clubs that actually were just a ball organization, and the fans screamed and yelled and booed, and well, times change eventually.
I thought Rod Carew was pretty good too. He was pretty cool in that first twin spot too.
And then about a week later, he left Twins.
Yeah,
we're all together.
Well, let's talk about this disco show that aired. What was it on KTSP? No,
this was WCCO. This was a show that was on. It wasn't disco. It was called This Must Be the Place. It was on at midnight for about 15 years or so. And Bill Carlson, who hosts it, he was kind of one of those guys that did voiceovers, he did news, did everything on WCCO for 50 years. And he hosted the show. It'd be like movie interviews or clips. And again, you got to kind of keep in context. There was four channels. Now, the disco show, the great thing about this, and when you watch it, is the dance instructor is very enthusiastic. And I did look him up on the Facebook. He did respond, and he thought that was the best thing he'd seen ever. He's still teaching dance out there. Yeah.
Still teaching dance, you say? All right, let's watch a little bit of what's the name of the show again?
The show is called This Must Be the Place.
This Must Be the Place. This is the disco episode.
Talking with Gary Stefan, and you recognize this lady, certainly.
Not the late night crowd. They don't recognize me.
Oh, yes.
They're not up at noon, you know?
my partner on midday, Cindy Osborne, with us, and she had to be here because of you really love to get down and do a little disco.
I sure do, especially with Gary. Is it all right to have a crush on your dance teacher? Is that okay?
Quite all right. Oh, I don't mind at all. Disco is nothing more than just taking steps and mixing a little bit of rhythm with it, and that's all it is. And there's very easy, simple methods of doing this. And we do this at Arthur Murray's, of course. You know, mm-hmm. Just come in and we'll start you out with basic. She had her first rock lesson today.
Right, today.
You know what? A little while ago, I said there's going to be precious little talk and a whole lot of dancing, and I think we should prove that right now.
Yes.
All right, let's everybody, come on, join us. Let's do some dancing.
I guess that was the morning show woman.
She's the movie host.
Okay.
Yorkshire is an organization that puts a disco anywhere. Is that right, Joyce?
That's right.
Your last name is?
Lipinski.
Joyce and Greg?
Greg Gregory.
Greg,
Gregory is my favorite.
You bring all kinds of folks' homes?
Oh, everything, lights, disc jockey, music, sound equipment, and, of course, the dancers.
How important is atmosphere to a successful disco kind of experience?
Well, a party is people, and people's a party. And that's what Arthur Murray's is all about. We want to put the people on the floor, get them moving their feet. Greg has got the best sound systems in the world, and we got the best dance steps in the world, and here we go.
Now, what if someone says, but I don't have that big a home. I can't do that. You can do varieties of it.
Oh, yeah. We can, if they've got a small room, we can work in that. But, I mean, it can't be that small. He's got to be able to move around.
Was Greg Gregory one of the guys in Clockwork Orange?
Oh, this was at the end, a commercial.
In Germany, they say, das ist Gemütlichkeit. But here at WCCO-TV, we say, tune in Sunday morning as Mo Howard stars in Oui, Oui, Monsieur. Then Larry Fine will appear in Tassels in the Air. And finally, Curly Howard stars in Blunderboys. Put them all together, you have the Three Stooges. John Gallus inviting you to join us Sunday morning, 9:30.
Look at their, I thought Joe would like the animated logo there.
I do like that, I like cats.
It's usually a Jerry Rafferty song with an animated cat. There's about maybe a half dozen of those on the website. And thankfully someone had a beta tape that they had taped several World of War episodes. And then This Must Be the Place was on right afterward, which made my night when I found that. And used that in many live shows.
So you say somebody taped that, but who, do you know like where you got that footage from?
So that particular tape actually came from the host, Bill.
Okay.
He's no longer with us, but his wife, who also was a host here in Minneapolis, Nancy Nelson, was generous enough to give me a storage locker of tapes to use. And
wow.
I'm still sifting through them to this day. And much gratitude to both Bill and Nancy for the tape collection.
Let me play something from that's like a promo for Eyewitness News. This is a quick one. Let's see, where is it? Oh, yeah.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dr. Walt Lyons, sportscaster Tom Ryder, and Stan Turner for anchorman Ron Majors.
Good evening, everyone. In the headlines this Tuesday evening, Richfield adopts a new ordinance banning nudity in the bars in that Minneapolis suburb. We'll check that out more fully for you tonight. We'll also tell you about the Wakota Arena issue in South St. Paul, that issue to be put before the voters next Tuesday. And we'll take you to the grounds of the State Transportation Building, where a veteran state employee planted a maple sapling on the occasion of his retirement today. But energy and energy conservation is what tops the news this Tuesday evening.
Can you imagine when, like, the news was that? People planting a sapling and then a ban against nudity? Like, those were the good old days.
I missed those days.
That was the 70s, right? This is when life was rough, right? In the 70s?
Late 70s, yeah, 1979. I mean, that's all that was in the news that day. That's fantastic.
Well, but I was trying to think, like, what is the nudity that would be in bars? Like,
what, t-shirt contest, maybe?
Oh, maybe that's it. Maybe it's a t-shirt contest, yeah.
It's a suburban city, too, which I can't think of anything in a suburb that had a nude bar. I'm struggling to think of which that could have been, but apparently it's an issue the council took up.
That was the top story that night.
It was top story that night.
Stan Turner reporting.
Stan is a good friend, actually. Stan.
Why is he dropping names? I love it.
Stan is, and he's one of these mains, Minnesota, we have a lot of mainstays. So the people that you'll see on the site, and by the way, Stephen Shen are easy to poke at a bit, but everyone that comes to Minnesota stays for about a decade or two, and the tape library or the content library grows. And then when they leave town, they give to me, and then it goes on tcmedianow.com.
Nice.
Is that what motivates you? Is it nostalgia from growing up with these guys? Is it like seeing familiar faces again?
Yeah, a bit of that. And also, it's one of those things where, 20 some years ago, if you want to collect something, no one was collecting this. It was the easiest thing to collect because everyone's getting rid of it and said, take it, please. Other people are searching up things that are high-priced, baseball cards, action figures, you know, jerseys, whatever it is you do. Same thing, I started going to estate sales. It went from my own collection to estate sales and then to Goodwill. And then I started emailing people like, do you have tapes? And like I said, people will say to me afterward, I don't know why I gave you my tapes, but I did. And I will send them to you UPS from whatever town I ended up in. So it's...
Thank goodness, though, because no one else was saving this stuff, like you said, you know?
TCMedia is a 501c3. So the mission of what we do is it's local content, it's local culture, it's local history. And you can take whatever you want from it. Take the hairstyles, take the music, take the the nudity ordinances, you know, whatever you want to take from it and learn from it. And on my social site, I usually put on this day in history. And it can be from very frivolous things. And I do try to put some serious things once in a while, but I do try to be a bit comedic because it's a lot easier to look at history than to be too serious.
Especially like the old commercials. Here's some local commercials. I think it starts off with one that was maybe national and then it gets into some local stuff. So this is another, some more local.
I didn't smile once in any of these pictures.
Know why? My teeth. I had awful cigarette stains. I tried one thing after the other until I discovered Topol.
Topol?
Topol, the smoker's tooth polish.
Think I'll get some for Bill before we take off on that 8-week training program.
Topol tooth polish helps remove all kinds of superficial stains.
Ruth, you're back. How was the trip?
Great. Oh, and so was Topol.
Bill used it.
He loved it. And now his teeth are as bright as yours.
Get Topol, the smoker's tooth polish, now with or without fluoride.
Live from Donaldson's, it's Saturday night. It's live Saturday night from 5 to 11 p.m. at all Donaldson's.
Hi, folks. Kurt Falstead from Mighty Metro Dad.
Yeah.
That commercial was used way after that was relevant. So you watched that like in the late 80s and no one knew what that joke was.
With the Chevy Chase like spilling thing?
They're ahead of their time.
I was a bit young for that era of SNL. I had no idea until I was older to really watch reruns what that even meant.
I just assumed that was from like 1978, but I guess
it is. And they aired it for about 10 years because they keep re-airing that every sale.
Got it. All right, this is my personal favorite. It's a local car dealership.
Hi, folks. Kurt Falstead from Mighty Metro Dodge. Boy, am I excited. Out here in Anoka, we got that incentive money to pass around, and I've given orders to Larry Falstead, the new car manager. to make those deals, give those fantastic trade-in values. Here's some fine examples. The Diplomat four-door delivered at $51.88. The Aspen four-door delivered at $46.66. And remember, folks, before you buy, be sure you try a Dodge at Metro Dodge.
And Kurt Polstad, the real great guy.
What does he say at the end there, Tom?
Oh, that's a great guy, Kurt.
Yes, play it again. Go back on.
And I also like how there's a bit of awkwardness at the moment where he doesn't know what to do with the mic. He just kind of hands it back.
30 takes, now is best one.
Yeah.
Dodge at Metro Dodge.
And Kurt Polstad, the real great guy.
Yeah, I watched it for years. I still can't understand what he's saying. And that aired literally at 5 a.m. because that was one of those tapes that the late movie rolled over 4 hours. And right before the sign-on, I think, with the American flag, we got the got that commercial.
We should include that in our – when we end the show, we put a bunch of short clips of people saying goodbye and that kind of thing. Let's add that to the ending of the show. I think that'd be a good one.
Yeah, whatever he says. Somebody is a real great guy. I want to show part two of the Good Company afternoon show. I didn't think it could get better, but after that segment about talking machines, they had this.
And Beth Wood was able to meet an exercise expert who showed her how to do two things at once, clean the bathroom and get your exercise. Here's
this
Beth.
Is a lady who is going to change my life. She is Ann Dugan, and Ann has invented a program of exercises you can do when you're cleaning up your bathroom.
Yes, what else would you do in the bathroom?
I don't know.
All right, now, as long as you have to clean your bathroom every day, you might as well toughen up your body while you're toughening up the
like
routine here in the bathroom.
Okay, make.
Cleaning up. Ready? Let's go. Unsinkable shy. Lift the leg. One.
Oh!
Higher. Three. Change. And one.
What's this for?
Two. Thighs and waist.
Okay.
Get rid of that dimples. Okay, let's go on to the next one. Hurry up.
Boy, a real
rub it up tub, Beth.
That's what this exercise is called. Rub it up tub.
Heavy duty cleaner.
Okay.
So you get a fluid action. Put the hand on the knee. Press the thigh forward as you're cleaning the bathtub.
What's this for?
Now, this is for saddlebags on the side of the thigh overhang,
saddlebags.
And cellulite bulge on the back of the leg.
I need this one. I better get in there.
Orange peel skin.
It's great. You get rid of your soap scum ring and get rid of your cellulite at the same time. I think I'll like it. What's next?
All right, next we're gonna get up and clean the shower or the back tile. All right, move to the left. Way down, bend. Two, three. Four, waistline, love handle, cinch in that
goodbye,
waist.
Yes.
Okay, let's go.
What's next?
Our next is kick it clean.
Kick it clean.
Kick it clean.
Great. Okay, this one's for floor cleaning.
This is called kick and clean.
Okay, kick and clean.
Where are they?
All right, now you bring the knee into the chest. Extend the leg down and back. The lower leg's up. Now this is for the low back and the hip.
Wow, this is like trying to chew gum and walk at the same time.
Pull up that drop seat.
Nobody has ever done this before.
Okay, kick it clean.
That's right.
Now what's this for?
This is for the low back and the hip. Flabby seat.
Now what do you do for flabby inner thighs?
Flabby inner
this
thighs.
This is for those muscles. Get the thighs parallel to the floor, hip low, and simply lift the heels up and down.
Okay, what's this exercise called, Ian?
Dip and disinfect.
Oh, I love it.
And
get rid of those
inner thighs.
This is terrific. But you know what, Ian? I think I'm ready to try your workout.
Go for it.
Have fun with it. Probably get flagged for this one, but I don't care.
A little bit. It's really loud. Not actually watching it.
Not a riot.
Isn't that a riot?
Isn't that a riot? That's such a Minnesotan thing to say.
I wonder if this is a pre-Karate Kid or was this after Karate Kid? Because, you know, they're doing all the wax on, wax offs and the...
I'm thinking we know where that inspiration was. I think this is pre-Karate Kid, but
that's
after.
What I thought. Yeah. Yeah. Nick, I wish when we were doing press releases for fake things to morning news shows, we would have come up with exercising while cleaning your bathroom.
Exactly.
It's just such a stretch.
I know. I just feel like I just feel like this lady had a pitch and they just said, okay, I don't know. But yeah. How old do you think that woman was, by the way?
You know, 50-ish?
The elderly
woman?
Yeah.
Yeah, and the host had to have been late 20s, 30, probably had her.
Do you know the answer to it? Or?
Yeah, I do, because they say at the end that she was 55. And to me, she just seemed a lot older than that.
Oh, I was going to say 75.
Yeah, 55, so I guess 55. That...
No, but that's 80s aging. 80s aging is way different.
Short-cropped, perm, she got her hair set.
Better of her childhood than we did.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, this clip is amazing. I don't know where you found this one, but it's from... it's Jesse Ventura, pre-governor, just a wrestler and actor.
Having lived in Minnesota, Jesse would always pop in things locally once in a while. He tried sports announcing. He tried different things. And eventually he tried governing because that was a radio stunt. This one I found from – that was actually on the news, on 5 p.m. news. It said a cutaway for a feature section with Jesse Ventura.
Okay. Here we go.
Absolutely. There, you can see us. We're in a huge wide shot here. You know who this is over here?
I just met him, shook his hand.
But you've seen him on TV before, right?
Yes, I have. Okay,
well, that's Jeff Passolt. No, that's you know who Jeff is, but sitting with you is whom?
Jesse. This is the one and only Jesse the Body Ventura. Absolutely. Jesse, I got to say welcome to you, first of all.
Thank you.
Jesse venturing from the world of wrestling now to the world of rock videos. And maybe you got to explain why you decided to do this.
Well, the first thing I want to say to you, Passolt, is how can you dress like that on a beautiful day like today?
You don't like it?
I sure couldn't. You know, I was just out at Fat Cat Beach, you know, out there, Lake Minnetonka.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, where all the fat cats are. And, you know, the water's even kind of purple out there, if you know what I'm talking about. But no, I ventured into rock and roll real quick. I'll tell you why. Because I'm, what rock star can be a wrestler? None. But I can be a rock star and a wrestler. I'm unique.
All right. The music video, it's called Jesse Ventura's I Got the Body. Let's take a look at it.
The body rules.
The body rules.
I got the power. I got the speed. This body moves in the ring. It's my machine. It's my castle. It's my weapon. When I wrestle, I got the hands. I got the moves. I got the ways to get to you. You want trouble? You'll be sorry if you mess with this body. I got the body.
The body rule.
I got the body.
You got the Plato's Retreat Swingers Club t-shirt.
There it is. I got the body. The body rules. Jesse,
what'd you think of that?
I got to tell you, I enjoy watching you wrestle. I don't know about the music video thing.
Tom, TC Media Now is your archive, and you're still updating this. And
yes, we got plenty of tapes and machines there, yes. Correct.
It's incredible. It's amazing stuff. You could spend your entire quarantine just going through that website and looking for fun stuff, because you post the whole thing. Like, we post little snippets. You've got the entire, clips from all, like, you have the whole disco episode, you know, that's all up there. So,
great. And really, what a lot of people do is a lot of people to actually recreate that same moment of watching TV as they did when it happened 30 years ago. So they want to watch the full effect commercials and sit down at their computer or scroll through it. Either way you want to do it. And part of it also, it's easy for me to actually just put the whole thing out there then edit it. And I do, I'll edit some short clips once in a while for the social sites as time allows. But I'm working in volumes of bulks of tape, and I try to put as much stuff out there on online that I can. Sometimes I do have to edit a few things that are not appropriate for 2020. I do, there are some we look at things a little differently sometimes. Some commercials I will not put on, some news things are just not good, but for the most
part. I want to see these even more now that you're selling it that way.
Privately.
But I think you should put together some sort of compendium or like some sort of greatest hits of all of your collection into like an hour long, you know, just the funniest, just best parts, and give it to us.
Yeah, I know. Or just do it here every few weeks.
Yeah.
Back on.
I love to be back anytime. It's fun to be with some fellow collectors. And some
Well, keep doing what you're doing, Tom. And thanks for coming on and showing some of your highlights. TCmedianow.com.
Come on, let's see your raviolis. Show us 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 your raviolis.
Thanks again to Tom Osman, and we'll have him back. There's so much good stuff in there. And now it's time for nice things, right?
Yeah, let's do some nice things.
Did you bring any nice things or find any nice things in Wisconsin?
No, I haven't really left my parents' place at all. We haven't really done much. We went out on a boat and that was it. But I was in my parents' place and I found this nice thing, a postcard that my brother Alex sent when he was 8 years old. He was at camp and he hated it. And we were looking at it today and we were in tears. I don't know if anybody else will find it as funny.
Camp is simply the best already.
Camp is simply the best. They crossed out best. They put boring below it. Do you see it there? And yeah. They said, this is the only one they had. So that's the front of the postcard. And this postcard reads, "Dear Mom and Dad, camp is pretty boring. We camped out and barely had any food. The food here is bad, but I eat it anyways. It's boring here, so come early Friday."
Alex, camp is the wordsmith.
Camp is simply the best.
Some cool, fun confetti and wavy lines, and it's just boring. And they don't have enough. They don't have enough food.
Alex is a writer now too, by the way. So
yes.
I got a couple more nice things.
Sure, go ahead, and then I'll get to button contest.
Bric-a-Brac, the good folks at Bric-a-Brac Records in Chicago. They got a mother load of videos, and there's one that I really enjoyed, and it's this one, Beethoven the dog.
They put it on a Memorex, huh?
Uh-huh. And wow. They use the face label sticker for the front of the VHS.
Sleeve.
They put it on the sleeve, yeah.
Interesting.
And it's Beethoven the dog.
The dog. Yep, that's the title of that movie.
Yep.
By the way, Bric-a-Brac is open by appointment, I think. So you could, if you live in Chicago, go check out their store.
Those are my nice things.
So last week, Meat Clown sent some nice things. He makes buttons for us occasionally. We have Rebecca's artwork from Alf from Miss Junior America. We got a little Pudgy Wedgy pin and the VCR Party Unbelievably Cool logo there. And so we had a contest for people to send in a 27-word essay, and people really delivered on this. I'll read off a few of these. I deserve a button because I didn't say he stole the money. If a son existed now, I swear I'd bash his brains against the goddamn radiator. 27 words from Zach.
Wow.
If you fail to send me one of those buttons, the four of you will collectively have to come up with an alternative way to defecate comfortably. It's kind of a threat. But
okay, an alternative way to defecate comfortably, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm trying to think what that would be. I guess a colostomy bag, right?
Yeah, or maybe she's gonna take away your padded toilet seat. I don't know. Whisper the words to her, Pudgy Wudgy, and she'll be so overcome with love for a great feline friend. A tear choked whisper back, Pudgy Wudgy. That's from Chris, the tape keeper. And I think this is because he said his wife is a big fan of Pudgy Wudgy, so he wrote that for her. Then separately,
is that
I got
a reference? Is that a reference to Pudgy Wudgy? Is that...
No, it's just a very poetic way about talking about his wife's love for Pudgy Wudgy.
Okay.
Then I got this one, which I think might be related. It says, my boyfriend takes pleasure from embarrassing me in public. He knows a name that brings tears to my eyes every time. He need only utter Pudgy Wudgy. That's from Michelle. So maybe they're related. I don't know. I didn't get the full backstory.
Two Pudgy Wudgy references, though, huh?
Yeah. This one says, please pick this essay. No other essay gives you a possible Otis medley or the commercial of the water park where I got chicken pox in 1988. So I'm going to show you both of those videos. I don't know if this is legal or not, but they included a possible Otis and the water park where they got chicken pox in 1988.
This is a nice thing.
Here's the possible Otis.
You'll see the dedication in every single step. You'll see it in smiles when smiles are hard to get. We've dedicated our life to yours. Taking care to make your life the best that it can be. We've dedicated our life to yours. Chase, Lim, and Grace.
Wolf Chase Lemon Brace.
100% that's an Otis. There's no doubt in my mind.
It has all the hallmarks. Yeah.
There's no doubt in my mind that's an Otis. George, is there any way? Wait, what were they called? Wolf Chase? Let's call them right now.
Wolf Chase Lemon Brace.
What I liked about it was that up until the very last line, that could have been for about 750 different businesses. And
that's
then they were able to.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's why it's classic. That's why I think it's Otis. Yeah. Yeah.
It's just a cookie cutter. Make it for anything. Yeah.
Right. What, Nick, while you're reading off some more, tell me what that place is called. Wolf Chase what? And I'm going to call
him. I have
right
the
now,
number here.
Oh, you have the number?
It's okay. In Memphis.
You want to call him? Yeah, you want to call him?
Yeah, I will. This okay. is the number that's on the and commercial.
Just, yeah, and just ask them if they think that's an Otis. Say you saw their jingle.
Okay.
Make sure you say they're part of you find VHS tapes at thrift stores and garage sales.
Say sorry to bother you during a pandemic.
Yeah, but, yeah, yeah, I'm sure they're open at.
Thank you for calling Wolf Chase Lemon Brace. Press 1 for the Memphis location or press 2 to
for the Jackson.
Memphis.
Thank you for calling Wolf Chase Lemon Brace of Memphis, where we've dedicated our lives to yours.
That's from the jingle.
Our hours are 9 a.m. to 5 p.m.
I'll leave a message.
Okay.
25 Highway 64, Suite 103. Our fax number is...
The fax number. Maybe I should just fax them.
Yeah, just fax them right now.
All
right.
If you have reached this recording...
Just fax them a picture of George. No explanation.
Okay. Detailed message.
Again, thank you.
This is a long... Okay.
This is quality internet programming here. Oh, hi. My name's Nick. I'm calling from the internet sensation VCR Party Live.
And, where we find VHS tapes.
We find VHS tapes at thrift stores, garage sales. We've got
over 11,000. Yeah, over 11,000.
It's 11,000 now or more. And we actually came across your commercial. Somebody sent it in as part of an essay contest to win a button. And we loved the jingle and wanted to know who did it. It sounded like this guy Otis in Dallas, who does great jingles.
We don't know his last name.
I'm not sure of his last name, but I just want to know who did the
jingle. How many Otises are there, really?
Because, you know, how many Otises in the jingle world are there? So, yeah, give me a call back. My name is Tom Jacobson. My number is 608-219-4040. Thank you. All right. So
you didn't give your real number there, huh?
No, I didn't.
How are we going to know?
You're all saying you were Nick, so you went from Nick.
You're at Tom's house. He'll tell you.
Yeah,
that's true. Okay. And you did start. You did start off by saying you were Nick.
Oh damn!
At the beginning, you were Nick, and at the end, you were Tom Jacobson.
Well, that call was a real journey for everybody. By the
if
way,
this is Otis related. Press 5.
There's also one more. This is the water park commercial for where they got chicken pox in.
All right, look up their phone number. Sun's on the rise, temperature
too. Good for the summer.
Surf's up, baby, let's catch a wave. Meet me at Adventure River today.
Adventure River,
it's an ocean of fun.
Adventure River,
fun for everyone.
Adventure River,
we're making a splash.
Summer's never been so much fun.
Adventure River.
That little girl had the haircut of a 78-year-old woman.
Yeah,
back it up a little bit. Yeah, look at that. But she's already a lunch lady.
Yeah. Well, she's sort of a toddler Rem Lazar. I mean,
yeah, it is. yeah, it really is.
Yeah, that sent me on a deep wormhole of old Wisconsin Dells water park commercials today.
And now I see those places, and it just looks like a petri dish of just bacteria, doesn't it?
Absolutely. Like, well, do you remember when we were shooting our Dirty Country documentary, I had just gone on a water park with my girlfriend's niece and nephew, and at one point I scraped my knee on the bottom of the kiddie pool that's, you know, covered in – like grit or whatever it is to make sure you don't slip. And it was just a minor cut, but it got so badly infected that I had to, like, I got blood poisoning. I had to, like, go in and get antibiotics for it. And it was
blood poisoning?
Something like that. I mean, I remember the prognosis being like, it sounded really bad. It was like a month of just absolute not healing, oozing stuff coming out of a bandage.
It was like gangrene.
Yeah.
By the end of the documentary, that week shooting the documentary, it was like green and pus filled. And
yeah.
You almost ended up in that prosthetics commercial.
The Wolf Chase. You had to go to Wolf Chase.
I could have. Yeah. I almost went there. So the point is, though, I think we got, I don't know, maybe like 20 different entries. And I have enough buttons for everybody. So the contest is over. Everybody's getting a button.
Oh, always do that. That's just the weasel's way out. You don't declare a winner. You're because just like, everybody's a winner. No, we need one person to win.
That's right.
You lost, Joe.
That's weasel behavior, giving everybody what they want. No, I'm not weaseling out. I just thought we had enough buttons.
It's cowardly.
We got enough good ones. Actually, there's one that I don't want to give it to. Jesse Leonard said button 27 times. That's... I mean, I appreciate the fact that Jesse entered, but I don't know if that deserves a button.
I vote no.
Yeah.
Really? I don't know.
27 buttons? No.
Now Joe wants to give.
Who's the weasel now?
I just want to do the opposite of whatever Nick wants to do. Okay. That's basically it.
Maybe I'll send something weird, just like a weird random thing to Jesse for entering. But
I'll send him a letter.
So, thanks everybody for the essays. I really enjoyed reading them.
Everybody wins. How exciting. Huh.
Everyone who entered will be very excited.
That wasn't anticlimactic at all.
They've made the effort to enter. They all get a button. I think that's great.
Yeah, but now they're all going to think. You see, you're conditioning them to think like all they have to do is just like shit out 27 words and then they can get whatever they want. No, people have to work for this.
Well, I think Jesse was the only one who shat anything out. Everything else was very well-reasoned and creative.
Do you think he copy-pasted that 27 times, or do you think he actually typed out?
Good question. Jesse, if you're in the chat, write and let us know. And that's Nice Things, everybody.
All right. That was Nice Things. We did it. We knocked it out of the park. We did great. All right. Now it's how to watch cyber videos on the internet. Okay, Nick, you want to go first?
Sure, yeah. I found one that was sent in to me.
By the way, how's Talking Dongles doing? How did that go? Like, how many hits is it up to?
Well, we have 1.5 million subscribers. The last video had 2 million viewers on it. So, yeah, it's going great.
Really? I'm going to take a look. I'm going to just pop up on our YouTube page.
Yeah, our Patreon's through the roof. That's basically, you know how, like, Jay Leno didn't spend any of the money he made on the talk show? You would just use a stand-up money to survive?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I just use my Talking Dongles money to survive, and then this is just kind of a fun little thing I do on the side.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so
well,
this
I'm gonna
one.
I'm going to look up to see how many hits it actually
yeah,
has.
Yeah, check it out. So Tony V said that his parents' church friend in Michigan has a show called Jumpstart Ministries, and I thought the opening theme song was, you know what, I'm going to save the opening theme song for the end. This is what it looks like, coming straight down to the firewire into your smart device, formerly known as television. I'm going to save the song, and I'm just going to play the part at the end.
Okay.
All right.
It looks like it's going to be loud. Or is it not going to be loud?
It's a little quiet, but I'll put it down here. All right. So here's just the trailer for an upcoming event on Jumpstart Ministries. The song will be at the end. Coming up soon, Supernatural Expo.
back it up just 2 seconds. Just look, look at Chris Hardwick did every single credit on there.
Yep. Christopher Hardwick from Nerdist, I think. That was the
Chris
Nerdist.
Hardwick? Yeah. He did a lot of the heavy lifting.
He also plays the shofar horn. I mean, it just was like, it's like he did it for comedy, but he didn't. It's just like, get ready for a power explosion, and it's like, and it's this.
At any given moment, there are only three people in the audience.
Yeah. Oh, but
Every wide shot has three people in the audience.
I can't. If that's what Supernatural Expo 2 is, what was 1 like? So if you want to see more of Chris Hardwick's show, Jumpstart Ministries, I will show that at the end of tonight's episode.
Oh, yes. I love that. That's my new favorite.
That's pretty good. Yep.
George, what do you got?
Well, so you remember that Saturday morning cartoons pretty much ruled our childhoods, and I guess they were big from like the 50s to, I don't know, maybe 20 years ago when there's the Cartoon Network, and you know, you can get cartoons whenever you want now. So I don't even know if that they really show them anymore on Saturdays. But in the 70s and 80s, they were so big that they used to have each fall a primetime expo where they previewed all of the shows. And NBC's 1983 offering was something called the Yummy Awards, and it is completely unwatchable. And here's a clip featuring Ricky Schroeder and Dwight Schultz, who played Madman Murdoch on the A-Team. And remember, the idea for his character was that he was a mentally ill Vietnam vet, and that's like that's characterization for back then. But this is, again, this is a show for kids, Oh, here we go.
Tonight, from Hollywood, it's the first annual NBC Yummy Awards. As we honor the most exciting stars and nominated shows of Saturday morning television, with your host, Ricky Schroeder.
Silver Spoons, of course.
Welcome to the first annual NBC Yummy Awards show. You've heard of the Oscars, the Emmys, the Tonys, and the Grammys. Well, tonight, we're handing out Yummies, the only award you can eat. This is it. It's a golden ice cream cone filled with a specially chosen flavor that honors the brand new hits and returning favorite shows on NBC Saturday morning television. The Yummies are delicious, nutritious, and loaded with calories. This is really television to grow on. One of the great stars of the A-Team, Howling Mad Murdoch himself, Mr. Dwight Schultz.
There's nobody in the audience, right?
Hi there, and I don't know what to say here. It's Dwight Schultz here, or is it Howling Mad Murdoch? I'm confused about that. But there's one thing I'm not confused about. I'm no dummy about these Yummies. They are delicious. I mean, open my mouth and gag me with the Yummy. And to keep everything only up and up and up, we have two honorable gentlemen who will guard the Yummies until they are awarded tonight.
All right, so anyhow. So it's,
I wanted to see that robot with the Groucho class.
Cut it off right there.
The sound is off on, again, I found this on YouTube. The sound is messed up for the second half of it, but I'm going to show you just some pictures from the rest of it. You've got the guy from fame with the Smurfs. You got Teeny Yothers and Bozo the Clown. You got Kim Fields and Papa Smurf. And then you have the cartoons coming in to receive the awards, including Thundar the Barbarian, Princess Ariel, and of course Ookla the Mock. You can't forget that.
I love Ookla.
And Iceman, Spider-Man, and Firestar.
Iceman looks cool. I don't know who Iceman is. Is it Silver Surfer or is it Iceman?
It's Iceman. He was one of the X-Men.
Is he? Oh, okay.
Yes. But
Spider-Man looked a little off, but Iceman looked cool.
But there is something bigger that we need to talk about here, and it goes to, it's my first apology. Let's look at something from last week's episode.
Okay.
Interesting. So I don't know how I get to know Mr. T, but I would hear friends talking about how they loved Face Man. Was that his name? Face?
Just yeah. Face.
Face. And Murdoch and all this stuff.
Murdoch, well, man.
So, okay, yeah, so Joe and, doesn't know, but he's already making fun of Nick about calling him Face Man, but
the reason I made fun of him is because it sounds like something my mom would have said, like, oh, he's Face Man from the A-Team, and it was Nick who said it.
But even though he was called Face on most episodes, and I'll show you why I thought that, here is the A-Team Wiki, and unless Nick somehow got into Google and changed thousands of web pages. In fact, in the pilot,
nerd.
he was called Face Man. So I owe Nick an apology, but I would like to point out that if you look,
wait, why do you owe him the apology? I was the one who mocked him for saying
no. Face. But I said, if you heard earlier, I said I think they just called him Face, and here's why.
They're the A team. You know they're soldiers of fortune. They're the A team, helping people in need. Pretend that you're Hannibal, Murdoch, or Face, or maybe D.A. Baracus. You know which one is the case.
No. Anyhow, the point is that he was called Face on all of the toys, so which is why I thought he was called Face. But Nick, you weren't wrong, and I
Face Man is his birth name, though, right? I mean,
he was born Face Man. He was christened Face Man.
Yeah.
But I'm sorry, Nick, when I said
we have a way to apologize here, and that's to eat expired food. So
yeah, and so Steve, why don't you do that for me?
Steve, but yeah, let's get to Steve's apology. You were so convinced about how to pronounce Lucia, and you went out on a limb. You said you had spoken to her about how to pronounce it. You told us it was a certain amount of
the soul. Worst part is I did. I spoke to her.
Nick, I think you might be owing an apology because it's Lucia. That's her name. It's Lucia.
No, it's not.
It's Lucia. She had a phonetic thing in the comments.
She had it phonetically. L-O-O-S-E.
Oh, she did.
Yeah.
Okay. Lucia. Yeah.
Okay. I have no apologies this episode.
I'm going to stop talking.
It is two syllables, though. I will say I was right about that.
You were right about that, yeah.
I was wrong.
You were the one who said Lucia, right?
I thought it was Lucia, but I thought somehow we made Lucia into two syllables, and Nick was on point that that is three syllables.
Do you have the Batman cereal there? Did you get it? You received it. Okay, there. Okay, good.
I priority mailed this to Steve. This is Batman Returns cereal, so I think it's a couple years
1992.
Older or newer.
Yeah, no, I get extra 3 years.
Okay.
3 years. I've never done an apology before. I probably have owed a few, but I've never had to do an apology before.
But now you're apologizing for two because you're apologizing for George too. So
yeah, thanks, Steve. I really appreciate
George
this.
Is going to take his own. So how many do I have to eat? It? Oh my god! No,
I believe this is kind of like a rice check style with marshmallows.
Let's see it. Hold it up. Let's see it.
So these are the rice checks.
Yeah,
Like Batman.
These won't
movie.
Be that bad. These won't
there
be that
are,
bad.
No, there are. It smells terrible. I'll tell you that.
I feel like you should have to take more. I feel like you should have to take more because these are not going to be bad at all.
How about
like,
one marshmallow and one rice check?
I was going to say four of the rice checks and then one
marshmallow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or a sandwich with two rice checks with a marshmallow.
Yes, make a sandwich. Make a sandwich.
All right.
An apology sandwich. That's what these.
All right.
And hold it up to the camera, too.
Here is the Batman marshmallow.
Okay. Cool.
That's the blue. Smell. All
right. It's blueberry flavored.
By the way, the marshmallow smells better. This smells terrible. Whatever the checks.
Yeah, grains probably don't last as long.
Ugh.
Oh, Purina.
It is Purina, by the way.
It is Purina? Okay.
Yeah, I did look at that. I have been thinking about this all day and not happy about it at all.
Let me ask you this, Steve. Do you have a? How's your gag reflex? Like, are you on a short trigger? Are you?
No, but I tell you what. Like, I do have a sensitive stomach, so it probably will not happen here. But I will be for the rest of the night. Just
you'll feel off.
It'll be in your head. It'll be in your head the whole time. Or
I don't know. We'll see.
And you'll think twice about how to pronounce Lucia next time. So that's the important part.
That's what's important.
That's the only reason I'm doing that is because I spoke to her. I wouldn't have done it for you guys. But we're going to do it for her.
All right.
She explained it to me.
Make a sandwich and hold it up to the camera so we can see it.
All right.
Okay. There we go. All right. Down the hatch and chew.
Open down.
Torture porn.
All right. Now, also, people should know that Steve worked on a show about expired food, a reality show about expired food recently.
That's so out now, he said. Ooh, he's not doing well.
Not good.
Yeah, I wanted gagging.
You know, definitely not gagging. I imagine it's probably better than the, but it's got like a foul aftertaste.
Steve, will you make a promise to me that if you do throw up during, like if you have to throw up, you won't run off camera, you'll do it right here?
I have to run off camera because I'm not at my house.
Or if it happens, later tonight, just videotape yourself because we got to have some closure.
Drive out to Wisconsin, get to Joe so he can watch in person.
Yeah, I can just pull out my phone and just.
I will say this: I'd rather do this than the original Batman.
That one's the worst. That one is like. That's why I haven't made any mistakes.
I smelled the other one. I was like, no, thanks.
That's the big reason. That's the big reason I haven't made any mistakes on the show lately is because I do not want to eat that Batman cereal.
Mm-hmm. Right. Like saying it's Lucia, for example, a mistake like that.
Well, that wasn't a mistake. That was just an error.
Okay, all right. Just asking questions. Yeah. Steve, do you have a cyber video?
Can I drink this down to wash this down, please?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And by the way, that show is called Eating History on the History Channel, isn't it? The Eating Expired
yes.
Food. What a cyber video do you have for us?
So I've had an interesting one. Someone, once again, I always depend on Melinda's to help me out, and I'm gonna Ashley Nine Lives sent this one in. From Maine, huge fan, but she found, or he, I'm sorry, I don't know, Ashley, and to put it here, I don't think so, but, they sent in a number of clips from, this is tough to explain, but basically what it is there's a museum called the New Museum, I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but
I think it's the Newseum in D.C.
Thank you. Yeah, so it's a museum, that's exactly what it is, in D.C., and basically it's a museum for news. But one of the things they have is they, you can create your own newscasts and they're immediately uploaded to YouTube. And so a lot of the people coming through are, you know, teenage or junior high kids, and they're going to make videos. And if anyone was like I was when they were that age, you're not going to take it seriously. You're just going to clown. So there's a lot of fun stuff to find. So let me show you a few of them.
I like this already.
And there's so much more.
I was getting worried about your setup for a second.
Well, I'm excited. I take my page from you. I don't know how to set anything up, but the video hopefully.
What are you talking about? I set these things up perfectly.
No, you took a gulp mid disc that made me worry about how this was going to end.
You might have to turn it down a little bit.
That's smart. Thank you, guys. I'm still.
I like already his name. His name already.
All right. All right. So
here it is. Steve, here's the other thing that you do wrong. I'm just trying to help you. After you hit play, move the cursor out of the way so the thing goes away.
I know. Okay. Yep. I say I know, but I never do it. All right, here we go.
What's up, bitches? I'm Bennett Spear reporting from the Verizon Center of the Washington Wizards, bitches. A slimmer, stronger John Wall is looking like a badass mofo playing in the deepest season playoff and shit. The team is counting up on this bitch so he can play and kick their asses and whatnot and all this shit. So, if you don't work too soft with the strategy, this might end up badly. Despite the recent losses, this motherfucker, Randy Whitman, remains confident in his team's ability to succeed and shit. It's clear that the Wizards are looking at some magic basketball shit to happen.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy iTouch Babies here, back with another Daily Dust in the video. Today's video, we are going to be talking about how to sauce a woman. Step one, text the message. Hello, that's what you're gonna send, okay? Step two, sauce. You're gonna put some like ravioli and stuff and like just sauce her up. Step three, you know what step three is. Step four, propose. Step five, FDB.
Hello there, Washington. This is Cade Mobley here. Gonna talk about the act. If you don't get your hand out, I will cut you. Get the fudge away. Right now. I will cut. Oh my god! I will cut your freaking finger off. Move! This is the act. Oh my god.
Mobley, it's okay. You'll be alright.
This is Cade Mobley. Goodbye.
Body. Dude, oh.
So that is just a little snippet of there's so many wonderful things in that
video. I'm so glad because like who would have thought that's another like thing like IMGs where it's automatically uploaded to the Newseum's YouTube page and you could just scroll those for hours.
Oh man!
Wow,
that was gold.
I got some tears on that one.
Oh, that's so good.
Speaking of,
I want to go to that museum, and yeah. I want to show my butt on. I want to do the butt. I probably couldn't because it's probably in front.
Oh, I think you could, Joe. That's the defeatist attitude. You can do it, buddy.
You could until the police arrive.
If there's a way to show my butt on the museum video,
if you could do it. In the All-Star music video at a Denver amusement park. You can do it at the news.
That's what I'm referencing. That's exactly what I'm referencing. Yes, IMG. So I spent all day today. I'm a week behind on my IMG emails. If you have sent me IMGs, I'm a week behind. But it's because I have so many. And today I spent all day. My niece and nephew are running around. I haven't seen them in ages. And I'm looking at IMGs all day today. And I'm not complaining about that. It was actually a very great day. I found some great IMGs. I found four. For people who don't know what our IMGs are, if you take IMG and you follow it by four numbers in a search engine in YouTube, go to YouTube, go to the search, IMG, four numbers, you'll get so many videos that were accidentally uploaded that usually have about 2 views, 6 views, 11 views. And nobody's seen these. They're not supposed to be on YouTube, but there's some gold here. So I'm going to show you my top four from this week. This first one, Christopher sent this one. This is IMG 0632. It has 1 view, and his description was cutting a heart shape into a dog's hair, which I like dog's hair instead of dog's fur.
Right.
Yeah. So here's what Christopher sent. Is that a thing?
Yeah,
is that a thing that people do?
I think it's a corgi thing. Like,
it's a corgi thing?
Yeah, corgis have like big butts, so they sometimes will do like shave things on their. Yeah, I mean it's for weirdos, but it's like, you know how they do those poodle grooming competitions? I feel like it's like that.
Okay. Well, that was
I love the soundtrack for that.
That's my number four. Coming in at number three, Andrew sent this one. IMG 1085, 3 views. Two women who want to help you. This is his description. Two women who want to help you buy or sell a home and also celebrate Run DMC's 35th anniversary. And then in the description at the bottom, it says, this is what they wrote in the video that got 3 views. We are celebrating Run DMC's 35th anniversary with this fun parody video.
Real estate is our recital. We think it's very vital to buy a home, to sell a home. It's tricky, isn't it? It's tricky to buy a home, to sell a home. Oh yes, a home is tricky. Tricky, 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 tricky. It's tricky to buy a home, to sell a home. Oh yes, a home is tricky. Tricky, tricky, tricky. Embargo sellers call us to find someone to buy. John talks the talk and walks the walk to save the finest time. We really love our city, except in winter time. Amber puts her clients first and know that ain't no buy. It's tricky to buy a home, to sell a home. Oh yes, a home is tricky. Tricky, 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 tricky. It's tricky to buy a home, to sell a home. Oh yes, a home is tricky.
South Dakota.
Is that where it was? South Dakota? I couldn't read
what it looked like to me. I don't know.
Yeah, either South or North. One of the Dakotas.
Yeah, and they got a license plate that said Run DMC, and then they did a fun parody.
Yeah, that was fun.
Run DMC's 35th anniversary for Berkshire Hathaway's the real estate.
Makes sense
Ambrose.
To me.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a long walk. But
We're in the trademark DC yellow hats that...
Yep.
They didn't even get the shoe brand right.
Nope. All right, so that's coming in at number three. And coming in at number two, Dave Hawkins. You remember Dave Hawkins? He got the big lip that was
the shellfish allergy
at the sushi place. He made the lip smacks. He sent IMG 1243, 21 views, pretty decent. He goes, this one is special. All I could say is, dear God. And this is technically a Joe's Filth Corner, but I don't have the graphic ready to go. So consider this Joe's Filth Corner within how to watch cyber videos on the cyber videos on the internet. Here's from Dave Hawkins.
Really? Really? I think this wall.
What kind of people chit chatting?
Sorry.
Oh, that's a mouse.
No, this is the wall.
Yep.
I don't know what that is.
Do you get a lot that this is kind of disturbing?
There's a mouth there, and there's...
coming out of something.
Wearing a mask.
Of gum?
See, I feel like this is at like an art gallery, and somebody records something at the art gallery because you hear people chit-chatting.
Yeah.
Sacrifice.
It's a sorority initiation.
Yeah, this is hazing.
But he saw that, and yeah. He
thought of you. You. Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that was sweet. So
that was
Number one, this one, I only watched it twice because I didn't want to get burnt out on it because I wanted it to sort of be fresh when I watched it again. Roboito sent this one. It's IMG 1149, has 9 views, and it's a man explaining a Taco Bell-sponsored game. And there's a lot going on. And in my 2 views that I watched, so on the right side of the screen is a completely different video, and on the left side of the screen is a completely different video. If you cover up one side, you watch a completely different video. This one is so good. This might be my favorite IMG so far.
More than
the
iguana tries to escape swimming pool?
Well, that one was legitimate. That one was genuinely legitimately funny. I think this one is what IMGs are all about.
Okay. All
right. You know what I mean? You don't normally see legitimately AFV funny videos.
Yeah, it's more like Rocks Are Done, Gotta Go.
Rocks Are Done, Gotta Go. Yeah, exactly. This is a legitimate, this is like what it's all about. Here it is.
Good for you. I have.
So keep in mind, he's explaining a Taco Bell sponsored game.
Okay.
And this guy on the right is
kissing a woman.
I have, as you guys can see, this is a Taco Bell icons that are all around the board. Taco Bell is graciously giving me permission to use.
They're not listening.
This is like me trying to explain every new board game.
That's another reason I loved it. It reminded me of you explaining board games when everybody else is talking.
Teaching all kinds of people. This one is, the focus is money skills. So you can see we have a menu.
I want this game, by the way.
Yes, by the way, we have the menu here.
We have a menu here. When we land on it, I'll have things for you to do. These are really good.
Somebody left.
Here's an old Taco Bell menu from 1972. You guys remember Taco Bell?
Tending to listen.
Right? Yes. So, I'll
be
right back.
Holding two ladies' hands right now.
And that's all I was going to say. Then on the right side, you got this guy holding two ladies' hands.
Wow.
And he was just making out with that new, with the woman on the left. And this guy, okay, hold on. The ending is really good.
Thank you. So, I'll be right back. I forgot one of my things. Okay.
That's how it ends.
I'll be right back. I forgot one of my things.
Yes, that's number one.
This is like me trying to explain scythe while I'm at a swinger party or something. This is what this is.
I just want you to watch that ending one more time, just because it's just it's a one person leaves while he's trying to explain the game, and
these are really beautiful pictures.
Really beautiful pictures of this Taco Bell sponsored game.
Taco Bell menu from 1972. You guys remember Taco Bell back then, right?
Yes.
So I'll be right back. I forgot one of my things, okay?
And then the phone rings.
Phone rings. Oh. Just make out amongst yourselves. I got to go get the thing I forgot.
What did he forget? Like a Taco Bell piece or something?
Yeah, probably like a pawn or something.
He was holding up a card that said Live Moss. Because remember, that was their slogan for a while.
What is that game? Like, it's so unwieldy. It's gigantic. I mean, it's...
Yeah, it's a Taco Bell sponsored game. And he goes, they were gracious enough to allow me to... He got permission to use this game to play at this weird... Where are they? Is it like a...
Retirement home, probably.
Yeah, it looks like a retirement home. Yeah, and that one woman was like an attendant who left. She didn't even be there. It was a game for the seniors.
Now, I had always heard that at retirement homes that they get laid like crazy, too. Right?
Really?
Like, and I feel like that guy was one of those guys who gets laid like crazy because like he was like... holding hands with that woman, then she showed up, and then he's kissing her, and then they all hold hands.
Yeah.
And they're all about to play the Taco Bell game.
No one's listening.
You can't even have dreams like this. Like, if you, like, this is weirder than a dream you might have. That's what I love about that, IMG.
That's a Hall
so
of Fame IMG. And to say, you're behind, but if you want more, if you want to join the team, are you still accepting applications?
Absolutely.
Okay. Info at foundfootagefest.com.
We're up to 2,500 IMGs that we've harvested.
Oh my God.
And if you info at foundfootagefest.com. And I will send you 20 different numbers. So I send you 20 different numbers and you watch all the IMGs. Somebody told me that there are DSCs too.
Yeah.
There's DSC.
Whole new world. That's the sequel.
Exactly.
That's like the nice cameras.
Yes. Anyway. Well,
we're running long, so we should probably wrap up here. We're taking our, this is our 2-week hiatus from Quarantine Classics and Frenchie and the Creep. So nothing on Wednesday, nothing on Saturday. But on Thursday, we are doing Welcome to My Home, the Brenda Dixon. We're watching that in its entirety on Thursday. If you're a Patreon member, patreon.com/foundfootagefestival.
I had never seen that one before, and I was skeptical of it. And it's a soap opera star who made this vanity video, and it's, what is it, 20 minutes long, 18 minutes long?
Yeah, it's about, something like that. Yeah, it's like 20 minutes, yeah.
And I guess you would order it in the back of magazines, and she would just give a tour of her home, and it feels like she's making it up as she goes along. I think she probably is. And I was skeptical about it because I'd never watched it before. I was like, what's all the hype about this one?
Yeah.
And maybe like 7 minutes into it, I was like, oh, I get it yeah. Now. I understand.
Just for her cat alone, I think it's worth the price of admission. So join our Patreon. Come watch us watch Welcome to My Home. Joe gets to see it for the first time. So that's it. We'll be back next week. Everybody will be in New York. And that's all that's it.
What are we leaving everybody with?
We're leaving everybody with Jumpstart Ministries, the opening theme song to his public access show on the internet.
Very cool. All right. Well, here's the thing. If we had been prepared, we could have done better. That's the truth.
And the other thing is that we'll be right back right after that.
I just want to tell everyone that everyone's a puppet when they're dead.
Da, 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 da.
All right. Good night, everybody.
Dr. Selner will complete the bunion surgery.
Yes, those are his pajamas he's wearing.
All right, I gotta go.
That's all. That's it.
Let me see that one.
Rocks are done. Gotta sleep. Bye.
That's it. That it had done.
We did our best. If we'd been prepared, we could have done better.
What do you think about Bibra?
About what?
My nose isn't for yuck anymore.
That's all I'm doing.
We'll be right back right after that.
And Kurt Polster, the real great guy.